Welcome, gamers. RetroPython here with another LaunchBox tutorial. Meet the Super Game Boy, released in 1994, a SNES sidekick that turned your Super Nintendo Entertainment System, or Super Famicom to our Japanese friends, into a Game Boy extravaganza. Plug in your favorite Game Boy or Game Boy Color games, watch them hit the big screen, and conquer Tetris while using your trusty SNES controller. Don't like the default palettes? That's fine, you can customize them. There's even special Super Game Boy Enhanced games that up the ante even further. The Super Game Boy 2 was released in 1998 in Japan only. It added a link port to allow the user to access two-player mode via the link cable, a green link LED, and a red power LED. The Super Game Boy 2 also runs at the exact speed of the original Game Boy, 4.194 MHz. The original Super Game Boy runs 2.4% faster than the Game Boy itself. Because of the speed difference, the Super Game Boy jumps every few frames. Now let's take a look at the Game Boys themselves. Designed by Gunpei Yokoi and his team at Nintendo's R&D1, launched in 1989, this handheld console by Nintendo changed portable gaming with its monochrome screen, cartridge system, and allowed players to enjoy popular titles like Tetris and Super Mario Land on the go. Now, jump ahead to 98, the Game Boy Color represented an upgraded version of the original Game Boy. It featured a colored screen that allowed for more vibrant visuals while remaining compatible with older monochrome Game Boy games. With an expanded color palette and improved hardware, the Game Boy Color empowered developers to create visually appealing games. The Game Boy Twins, classic in color, laid the groundwork for future Nintendo handheld gaming greatness. Think Nintendo DS, 3DS, and even the Switch. Yeah, they were the trailblazers. Today, we're showing you how to unlock the Super Game Boy experience inside a LaunchBox using RetroArch and a BSNES core. Ready to level up your Game Boy games? Let's go. So before we get started, we have to make sure a few prerequisites are met. Game Boy or Game Boy Color is already imported into LaunchBox using the RetroArch downloader. Now, if you didn't use the LaunchBox RetroArch downloader, just make sure that the BSNES core or any of its variants is already installed. A Super Game Boy or Super Game Boy 2 ROM is stored in a place where you can easily locate it. Now, in order to keep my installation of LaunchBox portable, I keep mine in my LaunchBox games directory. So essentially what we're going to do is we're going to create a secondary emulator. We're going to load BSNES to launch the Super Game Boy or Super Game Boy 2 ROM file. Then we're going to inject the Game Boy or Game Boy Color ROM into that ROM file. Don't worry, it sounds a little confusing. It's a lot easier than it sounds. Here's how you do it. We're going to go up to Tools, Manage, Emulators. We're going to add a new emulator. Now, initially, we're going to just type RetroArch. We're going to let it self-populate. We need to tell LaunchBox where RetroArch is. So it's going to be in your LaunchBox emulators, RetroArch, RetroArch EXE, open. Everything populated. We're going to change this to Super Game Boy. We're going to move over to associated platforms. Now we want to delete everything except Nintendo Game Boy and Game Boy Color. We're going to change our core to BSNES. We're going to uncheck default emulator. If your ROM files are zipped or RARed, you want to make sure you check extract ROMs. Now we have to tell LaunchBox where the ROM file is. So inside of here, extra command line parameters with a space. --\, games. I have my ROM file name in my clipboard, so I'm just going to paste it. --\subsystem-sgb. This is the path. This is the ROM file. We're telling LaunchBox that the Super Game Boy ROM file is located in LaunchBox games. I recommend you keep yours in that directory. That's where LaunchBox remains portable. We're going to select this whole thing, and we're going to paste it into Game Boy Color. So right now we have the Super Game Boy listed as a secondary emulator for both the Nintendo Game Boy and the Nintendo Game Boy Color. We're going to repeat this whole process for the Super Game Boy 2. RetroArch. Point to the EXE. Rename it. Super Game Boy 2. Associated platforms. Delete everything but Game Boy. And Game Boy Color. Change the core to BSNES. We're going to uncheck default emulator. If your ROM files are zipped or RARed, you want to make sure you check extract ROMs. Now we're going to point to our Super Game Boy 2 ROM. I have it in my clipboard. I'm going to paste it. We're going to highlight the whole thing, and we're going to paste it in the Game Boy Color section. And we are done. We now have the Super Game Boy 2 ROM set up as a secondary emulator for both the Nintendo Game Boy and Nintendo Game Boy Color. So now when you want to play a game as if you're using a Super Game Boy or Super Game Boy 2 attachment, all you have to do is right-click on whatever game, launch with, and then pick whatever version you want to load. As a default, LaunchBox will load your primary Game Boy emulator. However, now there's an exciting addition. You can opt for either the Super Game Boy or Super Game Boy 2. For this instance, let's fire up Aladdin using the original Super Game Boy. So as you can see, we're loading BSNES because the Super Game Boy ROM is an SNES ROM. And there's our Super Game Boy boot logo. And there's Aladdin. As you can see, Aladdin is a Super Game Boy enhanced game. You can tell by the fancy border. So we're going to hit L and R together to bring up the Super Game Boy menu. We have a couple of options here. First one is the palettes. We can cycle through these, find one that we like. There's several banks of different default palettes. Circle weird face to go back to defaults. Second option is the border. There's several different options we could use if we don't want to use the super enhanced border. The Super Game Boy 2 adds a few extra borders. Make sure you try that out. Again, back to the default. Third option is controller. You have type A or type B. Essentially changes one button. If you don't like the default palettes, you can use this option to customize your palettes. You could take colors from the right and place them in the palette colors on the left and swap them out. Find something you like. R goes back one. It does not save, so there is a password on top. C goes back to the default. Final option is the border. You can edit the border any way you like, draw on it. Let's set it back to the default border. L and R to get out of the menu. Let's try a quick game of Aladdin. Although the Super Game Boy and Super Game Boy 2 do elevate the experience, it's essential to remember that at its core, it's still a Game Boy game. Consequently, you're going to encounter those distinctive Game Boy graphics. But that's part of the charm, right? Let's exit Aladdin and try a Game Boy Color game inside of the Super Game Boy 2. There's the Super Game Boy 2. Boot logo. Mortal Kombat 4 is a Super Game Boy enhanced game. I honestly thought I was Sub-Zero. All right, let's check out some other games and do some comparisons. That wraps it up for today. Now, this setup method is excellent because it lets you utilize your current games and virtually replicates the action of putting a game into either Super Game Boy or Super Game Boy 2. This emulation closely matches what we encountered in our earlier days. It adds a bit of nostalgia and is a wonderful addition to anyone's Game Boy collection. As always, any questions or comments, drop them down below. Stay tuned to the YouTube channel and LaunchBox forums. Lots of fun stuff coming. Until next time, happy gaming.